should we do a scary night vlog? We should. I agree. And yes, I chose to take the canyon. The safest way ever. Actually, I like this way better than the freeway because I know this canyon really well. And the freeway, you know, I don't like the freeway at night. There's so many potholes. I'm not down with that. I'm not down with hitting a pothole at 75 miles per hour, however fast I'm going. I'm sure the cars are paying close attention, like they usually are in Los Angeles. I do need to get, for nighttime riding, I want to get the reflective wheel tape, rim tape. I went to look at it, the reflective tape at Cycle Gear, but it looked kind of grayish. The one he showed me, which was, you know, listed as white. And I just want it to be really white because it'll match my bike. Because she mounts as a zebra. She can't be gray. She's black and white. Right, Shimama? She says nay. Do zebras even nay? I don't think they do. Ooh, I have a cool story about zebras. I've been to Kenya 2 times, and the second time I went, I was an adult. The first time I went, I was 13. The second time I went, I was horseback riding, and there was this, like, I guess it was like a plateau section in these mountains called the Abadir Mountains. And so it was kind of flat. It had, you know, like the plains, the Serengeti Plains, it had that kind of African, you know, feel to it. But unfortunately, the animals that were in this area, a lot of them had been poached off. Like, there was a few leopards, all the lions had been poached off. All the cheetahs had been poached off. The elephants used to migrate there, but I think that they stopped because of the farms and the poaching. But there were zebra and giraffe and wildebeest and Cape buffalo. And I was horseback riding, and we came upon a herd of zebra mixed with Cape buffalo. They're kind of friendly-ish to each other. They don't hate each other, but they're different herds, but I feel like the zebra are tolerated with the Cape buffalo, but the Cape buffalo are very territorial, as are hippopotamuses, which are horrible creatures that will eat you alive for reals. I'm not even kidding, they look cute, but they are really vicious. So the Cape buffalo, I wanted to go near the zebra because, you know, the zebras are cute and pretty. And there were some other, I forget what they're called. They're called zebroids or something. I think they're horse and zebra, or zebra and mule, or they're not full zebra, and they look cool. So, you know, I wanted to go closer to them. But the Cape buffalo herd was there, and the male, of course, you know, I mean, this is, you know, he's just doing as his instinct, you know, tells him, but he was being really overprotective, and we weren't gonna hurt them, but I can understand why he didn't want us there. So he would charge us, and we would, you know, run off with the horses and get a good distance, and then he would, you know, back off and go back to his herd. And We did that a couple times. It started to become like a little game. We would creep up to the herd, and then the male would get pissed off and chase our horses off. It was kind of dangerous, but I was with like a guide, and he was getting way closer than I was. I was sort of, you know, holding back because I don't know what can happen. It was pretty cool just seeing the zebra and all the animals and their natural habitat and stuff. Mm-hmm.